We begin with Allah's blessed name. We praise Him and we glorify Him as He ought to be praised and glorified. And we pray for peace and for blessings on all His noble messengers, on our father Adam, and our father Abraham, and on Moses, and on Moses, and on Jesus, and on His mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and on the last of all, the Blessed Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And we pray for peace, for mercy, for forgiveness and blessings on the soul of the Malcolm X of Cape Town, Imam Abdullah Harun, rahimahullah. We are happy to be here in Cape Town's Sharpeville, and this is Google Into. And if you don't know what is Sharpeville, then you have some homework to do. The subject of the return of Jesus alayhi salam and the end times is going to continuously increase in importance. And there are powerful forces at work, working insidiously to try to corrupt the subject so that we do not understand it and that we misunderstand it. In the few minutes that we have, we want to enter into the record. What is the correct view of the subject? When we are addressing a people who believe that the Qur'an is the word of Allah, we can of course turn to the Qur'an, which declares, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإنه لعلم للساعة وقبي رسائل وإنه لعلم للساعة. Surely He, Jesus عليه السلام, He is the sign par excellence of the last hour, meaning the return of Jesus عليه السلام is the sign of all signs. The last hour. This is what establishes the return of Jesus alayhi salam with the subject of the end time. But if you are addressing a gathering who do not as yet believe that the Quran is the word of Allah, then you need to use a different approach. So let us use that approach today. Islam tells us, or Islam presents to us, a picture or a portrait of Jesus, the son of Mary, in which everything connected with him is such that appearance and reality are different from each other. In Islam, we are told that he was born of a virgin mother. His mother was not married. The reality is that he was born of a virgin mother. But the appearance, for those who did not penetrate the reality, was something else. They said, since his mother was not married, he was a bastard. And so they missed the bus. And they slandered her name. She, who the Quran recognizes as the supreme woman in Jannah, in heaven. In the same way that appearance and reality were opposite to each other when he was born, so too When he departed from this world, appearance and reality were again opposite to each other. The appearance was that he was dead. The day had succeeded. He was crucified. And indeed, they boasted of how they had killed him. And then used sarcasm, referring to him as the Messiah, when of course they rejected him. That was their appearance. He's dead. How could he be the Messiah? Because the Messiah must rule the world. He must liberate the Holy Land. He must bring the Jews back to the Holy Land to reclaim it as their own. He must restore the holy state of Israel. He must cause holy Israel to rule the world. He never did that, he is dead. So he couldn't be the Messiah. And the book said, the holy book said, that whoever dies like that by hanging, and crucifixion is a form of hanging, is the cursed of the law. So clearly, he could not be the Messiah. That was the appearance. But what was the reality? No one knew. No one knew. For 600 years, no one knew. Until Allah sent down the Quran. And in the Quran, Allah revealed that he made it appear like that to them. And so he did not experience something called maut. Maut is when the angel takes the soul and does not return it. But can the angel take the soul and return it? Yes, says the Quran. And so in the case of Jesus, alayhi salam, the angel took the soul and returned it. And so he did not die. And Allah raised him. One day he's going to come back. One day he has to come back, because Allah declares in the soul, in the Quran, that every soul must taste death, including the son of Mary. The most powerful voice in history to have prophesied that Jesus, the son of Mary, will return is the voice of Muhammad, Allah's blessing be upon him. But when he is returned, when he is to return again, as it was at the time of his birth, appearance and reality were opposite to each other. As it was at the time when he left, appearance and reality were opposite to each other. It appeared that he was crucified. The reality was that no, he was not killed, he was not crucified. Similarly, when he is to return, appearance and reality would once again be opposite to each other. This is the heart of the subject of the return of Jesus alayhi salam and the end time. A man is going to stand in Jerusalem, ruling the world from Jerusalem. In the same way that Jesus alayhi salam performed miracles, this man is going to be doing miraculous things. And this man is going to declare, I am the Messiah. And lots of people are going to be deceived and accept him as the Messiah. But that would be only appearance. The reality is, no, he's not the Messiah. No, he's someone impersonating the Messiah. No, he is the false Messiah. No, he is Dajjal, al-Masih al-Dajjal. And the true Messiah is still to come. What's going to happen when the true Messiah comes? The Qur'an tells us that when Jesus returns, وَإِن مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ. This is in Surah An-Nisa. That every Jew and every Christian will have to believe in him. And so Harun Yahya, whoever he is, because this is only the shadow, we don't know who the man is. Scholars of Islam don't walk around with shadows. Scholars of Islam put their face before the people so we can see who you are and we can talk to you. We don't hide behind screens and pen names. That's not a part of our civilization. Tell that to Harun Yahya. Harun Yahya would have us believe as though we have eyes and yet cannot see, that since when Jesus returns, the Jews are going to believe in him. That's what the book says. And the Christians are going to believe in him. That's what the book says. And the Muslims are going to believe in him, because we already have that thing. So all of us are going to live in one nice family. Jews and Christians and Muslims are all going to live together as one happy family. According to this lie, since we're going to live like that when he comes back, well, why don't we live like that now? My gosh, the Israeli Mossad is really good at it. No, that's false. That's not true. And Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam tells us that's not true. When Pharaoh was drowning underneath the water, something happened. No one knew until the Quran was revealed that at the last moment when he was dying, then he realized, I'm not God. Before this, he was claiming to be God. But now he realizes he's not God because he's dying. So now at the last moment, he declares his faith. And then he dies. But goes into the hellfire according to the Quran. But Allah responded to him and said, now Pharaoh, now you declare your faith. When prior to this you were in obstinate and arrogant rejection, and you were terrorizing the people and committing fasad, Pharaoh, today we've decided to preserve your body, so that when your body is rediscovered, it'll function as a sign for a people to come after you. A people who will live the way you live, will die the way you die. This is the key. So when Jesus returns and they see him, and this is not a Jesus that you hear about at Christmas time, the Lamb. No, this is the Jesus that Google Little knows very well, the Lion, who stands up against the oppressor. Google Little knows him quite well. when Jesus returns and they see him, now they know that they have been holding on to falsehood and terrorizing and tyrannizing the true followers of the deen, the true Muslims. And now they will die knowing that they're going into the hell's fire, because you can't doubt it, he is the Messiah. And so tell Harun Yahya for us, sending this message to Harun Yahya from Mughalito, that this is a lie. When Jesus returns, it's not going to be living like a happy family. No, what is it going to be like? The Prophet said, Allah blessings be upon him, and this hadith is in Sahih Bukhari. This hadith is in Sahih Muslim. This hadith is very firm, strong. You can't shake it, not even with a bulldozer. What is it? Is Harun Yahya listening? لَتُقَاتِلُنَّ الْيَهُودِ. You will most certainly fight the Jews. Is it all Jews? No. Why should we fight a Jew who denounces Israel for its oppression? Why should we fight a Jew or a Christian who struggles with us for the liberation of the oppressed and the Holy Land? Stop the nonsense. Not all Jews. You will fight those Jews who are oppressors, and they are the Zionist Jews. And now that they have shown what they want to do with Libya, I think you will see a number of Zionist republics now emerging in different parts of the world. I don't know whether South Africa is looking carefully at what's happening in Libya. لَتُقَاتِلُنَّ الْيَهُودِ. You will most certainly fight the Jews. وَلَتَقْتُلُنَّهُمْ. And you will most certainly kill them. You will defeat them. حَتَّى يَقُولُ الْحَجَرُ. At that time the stones will speak. Ya Muslim. These are not my words. These are the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 1400 years ago he sent those words to Mughalito. حَتَّى يَقُولُ الْحَجَرُ. At that time the stones will speak. Ya Muslim. هَذَا يَهُدِيٌ وَرَأِي. There's a Jew hiding behind me. A Zionist Jew, not a good Jew. The one who denounces the Israeli oppression. There's a Jew hiding behind me. فَتَعَالَ فَقْتُلْ. So come and kill me. And so, brothers and sisters, that's a lie. We must expose that lie today in Mughalito. The lie being perpetrated by Harun Yahya. It's not our style to call names. But this one we cannot avoid. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may bless us. That we may be able to understand this subject. And that we may be able to stand firmly on the side of truth. On the side of those who are oppressed in a struggle for liberation from oppression. And that we may be a people who, when Jesus returns, will stand with him as he liberates the Holy Land. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا يَا مَوْلَانَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ بِرَحْمَتِكَ يَا أَرْحَمَ الرَّاحِمِينَ.